Hello and welcome back to Jarvis Johnson Gold, the premium channel that is free.
Gold.
It is free, but
that's this one, right?
If you're watching this, you're premium. It's a very special episode of Jarvis Johnson Gold because we're coming to you with a finale of sorts.
Boy, have they waited.
A few years ago now.
Don't say that. Now I'm thinking about age.
Yeah, Jordan and I started watching a series. Critically, at the time, acclaimed series.
Emmy award winning.
Emmy award winning series called Black White, about two families that swap races. Forget about the fact that one of them looks like Jordan. What's that?
No. We didn't make this revelation until I turned up today.
Yeah, the black dad looks like white. Like, the white version of the black dad is hard to talk about.
Of the white dad on the black, the family.
Yeah, the white black dad is, it looks kind of like Jordan.
All right, come on, man. Are you saying that maybe I've been elaborately painting my face every day before I come in and record?
Yeah, so that's the thing about the show is that every day that they film, this family goes in and does Emmy Award winning blackface. The special occasion is, one, we're doing this in person. Two, we just released Sad Boys merch. Sad Boys being our podcast, a podcast about feelings and other things also, that we've done every week. You can check that out on YouTube. Just search up Sad Boys with a Z. We're also on Spotify and everything. But I'm actually wearing it. Our first podcast merch release. And so what is this, a crossover episode? I figured we'd bring the boys together.
What are we best known for?
And finally wrap this up. I do think we will try to release the full reaction on Jarvis Johnson Live once again for one last job, like Bruce Willis.
And then I'm all done. One last blackface.
So you'll be able to check out the full reaction over in those places.
What's that in the sky? It's landing in front of us. It's an education in race and diversity on behalf of an Emmy-winning show. This is going to be worth something. Save the film. Oh my God, a bunch of dust just came off.
I cannot wait to give a deep dive on all of this, but there's two discs, and one of the discs is black.
Ooh. And one of the discs is white.
Apologies, but we will not be watching the black disc today.
Yeah, out of protest.
We'll be jumping straight to the more powerful disc.
Previously on Black White.
Over the next several weeks, my family's gonna be living with the white family.
I have no idea what it's gonna be like to live with a black family.
This is such an understatement of what they're doing. We're gonna live with a black family, and that's the whole show.
And that's the whole show.
No worries. Surprise.
Commingling. Yeah, it's not like the most of these conflicts wouldn't exist if they weren't being put in the most ridiculous situation.
Yeah. They're not arguing about, like, you haven't been doing the dishes. They're arguing about, like, you gotta say, stop saying the N-word, actually.
During this project, I'm going to become a black person.
When I walked into poetry class, it just went like, whoa. Who got the idea that I was ready for this?
There's no one word. But when it comes to black and white,
I can think of more. When it bursts through the door, I have a few.
She's still in disguise at this point. So she's like, there's no one word that I can say.
It all turns gray.
I just felt like, that's it? Like, I didn't connect to anything.
It's just the poetry class is so honest.
It's almost like you're not speaking from the black experience.
Something's wrong. This is going to sound crazy.
I don't want to, like, deny your blackness because, of course, there's so much nuance to black identity in America, but there's just something that's not connected.
Rose is, like, nervously wiping her forehead. The makeup's coming off.
Yeah, she's, like, fingerprinted white forehead.
Cannot stand lying to them anymore. I live in Santa Monica. I've told you the truth since the beginning, except for the fact that I've walked in here in makeup, and that is the lie.
So a huge one.
The only.
I've told you the truth, except for my entire identity.
Wow, you told me your real
name. I am
name.
From Santa Monica, though.
Yeah. Are you worried about yourself at all?
Consequences, I don't think about them. I really don't care about them. That's the last thing I'm thinking about.
It's a bar. Consequences, I don't think about them. I don't care about them. That's not what I'm worried about. It's like a 16. Gucci Mane lyric.
Please don't believe the hype. Everything in the world ain't black and white. Wrong. I'm about to go right.
Black is me.
Oh, the king. If you a zebra, better come out them stripes.
If you a zebra, better come out them stripes.
Oh, that's right. Final week Project.
It's the social experiment.
How dare you?
This is like when they call Love is Blind a social experiment. Yeah. It is not.
I mean, if it was an experiment, why are there like 15 seasons of like, we're still not sure.
It is a, at best, demonstration.
We're doing a medical study and where we shoot you. Oh, we killed him again.
We're down to the final week of this project and things are so strained in the house. I think we've all had it with each other.
Why'd you say had it like that?
I felt like she held something back.
I think we've all had it with each other.
We've all, what you could say, getting sick of each other living in the house, if you catch my drift.
It's just really like, I'm living with you, Nick. I really wish you would just say you didn't like me or something tangible, because I don't know what the heck is going on in your head. Why are you on this project?
Why are you in this project?
What?
I didn't know he really got her like that.
It is very funny to criticize anyone when you have been doing blackface every single day.
Yeah. I'm sitting here in the makeup chair every single day to learn.
I'm here to help you, Nick. Hugh.
Things are definitely getting a little spicy around this house. Basically, one word is said, 6 different understandings. Even Mom and Renee are still talking about this bitch incident.
I thought we were going to be able to avoid it. The bitch incident, as shown in the edit, pretty cut and dry, where they were shown a page. It was like slang. And I think it was a situation where they were like, oh, can't the bitch be friendly? Like, yo, bitch. And then Renee was like, you called me a bitch?
Excuse me.
I never want to be on Carmen's side just because of everything else she said and done. Are they leaving something out that I'm not understanding here? Because this has been a multi-episode issue.
Right now, I'm just ready to go home.
To not be seen or loved, it's really hard. To live in a household like that?
Gosh, you guys should know how that feels. That's prejudice.
Of all the people that should know what that word is, it's your hobby, dude.
I expected not to be surprised in episode 6 of Bug Bite, but you of all people should know that's prejudice. Imagine you're mansplaining prejudice to black people and you don't even know what the word is.
I mean, you know. You know what that is. It's all new to
me. It's all prejudice.
You're being really prejudiced to me right now.
Prejudice is awesome.
Let's get that word on screen as he says it.
It's like the Dark Souls font. Prejudice.
Gosh, you guys should know how that feels. That's prejudice.
Honestly, deep down inside.
He is so close to Michael Scott. I can imagine Steve Carell, who I love, performing this perfectly. He says it with such a straight face, such a matter of fact, that's prejudice.
There's a conflict between some of the warehouse workers and he's like going down trying to be cool. You guys, you want to work these days and they don't want to work these days. But in a way, we're all brothers. You get it. And then like, and then it's like, that's prejudicism for that.
That's prestigism.
That's racist.
I honestly, deep down inside, think that Bruno is racist.
No. Wait, he's...
Are you coping with the fact that Bruno is racist?
I just feel like... Deep down?
Deep down.
Behind the veil?
Behind the veil. You may not be able to tell it from his actions up front. I am actually excited that Brian said this. Because he's right.
Tarantino movie?
I was the minority in the groups that I was in. So I got to experience to be the odd one out in ways.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I can go around.
That's not being the odd one out because you're black. That woman looked into the lens of the camera.
Yeah, she went, wait, why am I on camera right now?
Yeah, that's why she's uncomfortable.
Shouldn't I sign a release and then they just walk away?
Yeah.
I'm going back to my photography class and back to my white makeup just to hang out with the kids.
Let's head up.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. Nick would unironically be successful on TikTok today.
Dude, he would crush it.
He's got the best white guy makeup.
But he'd have to start going by like Brayden.
He looks like one of the Stokes twins.
A lot of guys like that thrive appropriating racial culture.
Wait, this is actually call the Wayans. I've got a new white chicks idea.
Whiter chicks.
Back to my white makeup just to hang out with the kids.
He says hang out with the kids like he's a retired Hall of Fame NFL running back.
Yeah.
And he's like, he's doing like a camp.
Trying to get at-risk youth off the street.
Right. Like, exactly. Hang with the kids.
Come do photography with me. I do not remember him being in a photography class, by the way.
Yeah, me either.
In the scheme of things, this area is nothing but a stereotype, right?
Insane. Oh, what?
Insane.
The fuck?
To do that.
Crazy.
Like they're at the museum.
What? Emmy Award winning, by the way.
Yeah, like those guys are built out of wax.
Yeah, on the back of the DVD, it says a groundbreaking and provocative new series.
Yeah, I mean, not wrong.
Yeah, I guess.
Groundbreaking like an earthquake.
Where it just fucks up things that were fine.
It is a natural disaster.
Yeah. Hey, we're going to interrupt this to sponsor ourselves. If you are so interested, we found out about a lot of DVD special features from this black-white DVD that I've been holding on to for years.
Special is something you could call it. They're definitely features.
I would call them premium features myself. We've got the makeup application slideshow where we can watch them apply Emmy award-winning blackface.
Sin.
We can watch the original casting videos. There's all 6 episodes with audio commentaries. We're going to be diving into this on our Patreon at patreon.com/sadboys. So you can check that out. And you can also check out all of the exclusive Patreon episodes of our podcast, Sad Boys Nights, of which we've got 70 episodes, you know, like over 70 hours of content that you can get for as low as $5 a month. Make sure to only use your discretionary entertainment spending on this. Don't,
no obligation.
Don't break
whatsoever.
The bank. No obligation.
Sign up for a month if you listen to absolutely everything, if you're a crazy person, and then...
Yeah, don't even worry about it. And while you're there, we are giving a little promotion. If you were planning to buy the merch already, you can get $5 off on the merch, which is going to subsidize your entire first month of our Patreon and get access to an exclusive patron colorway. It's a beautiful lavender blue situation.
We worked pretty hard to figure out what the name of the color is.
Yeah, don't look that up. But yeah, enjoy this, and there's a lot more to come, and we just wanted to get the boys together for one last job. And here we go, boys. Back on the job site.
The blackface job site.
I'm glad it's the last week of the project, because I'm just bored and ready to go home.
Respect.
I mean, Nick has always been a straight shooter.
He's so, like, down to earth with all of this stuff. It's really weird.
He's giving the producers nothing.
What did you do today?
We took pictures with the same class he was with last time.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Why does it matter?
Why do you think that it's okay for you to be so rude sometimes?
Why you keep asking me all these damn questions?
Hell yeah, brother!
He hates it here.
Why do you
now,
have to
he's
be so
being rude to Rose, but I don't know what their like relationship is. Also, they're both like teenagers, so they're rough around the edges, of course.
And the, I mean,
with their communication,
it's an edit. We're always going to miss context, and we're always going to get maybe the most provocative things. But with that in mind, he's just kind of being dismissive.
He is being dismissive. Yeah,
you don't owe anyone engagement.
I feel like I've shown Nick a lot of respect in this project, but he brushes me off, gives me major attitude. I don't like that.
We're not seeing it all. We're not seeing it all. And so I want to give all the minors here the benefit of the doubt. But Nick is being a jerk. And Rose is being annoying.
Nan and I are so tired of spending time with the Wurgles. We want to go out and have some fun in our white makeup for the last time.
I just want to say, how dare you say I look like him?
Well, no, not in this. No, only in this picture.
Oh.
Not in real life.
Yeah, you're right. This is.
But also, Brian's an attractive guy.
Yeah.
But not...
Hi.
Hello.
Brian and I.
Do you think they were told to walk like that?
Dude, brother, what is going on? Why did they dress them like cartoon parents? Like, no one has actually at any point in time dressed like that.
Dinner at a restaurant called Dish just to see what it would like to be a white couple at a nice restaurant.
I heard the food is just really awesome here.
Dude, Brian's in character.
Yeah,
he's in character.
Excellent. I heard the food's really awesome here.
Golly.
Oh, man. Just love being white. And then, like, doing this.
Yeah, he's like, did that track?
Young lady was in there by herself. And I looked over and I noticed that she got up and went to the bathroom, but she left her wallet on the counter.
Very curious as to why you would do that.
It's a matter of faith and human nature.
Okay. I mean, it worked out well for you. You know, I was kind of like, make sure, you know, myself, since I had the insecurity about it. But that's great.
Dude, I relate to him going, that's great.
Wow, that's great.
That's great. You know, at a cafe, somebody's like, hey, can you watch my stuff for me? And I'm like, I'll tell you if someone steals it. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to put my risk life and limb.
Hey, would you be willing to get into the trenches for me?
When you go to the restroom again, will you leave it again? Wow, that's pretty good.
Not everywhere.
Not everywhere. Tell me about the places you won't leave it.
The toilet. Probably.
Tell me about the places you won't leave your wallet and describe them in detail.
Probably with a black man in disguise.
Yeah, he goes, watch this. it. And then immediately frame one, the wallet like goes into her pocket.
Yeah, she like Luke's lightsaber.
Yeah, she like puts her hand up and then just like zips like a magnet into her wallet.
Stop.
My life has really become so much consumed by the poetry people, hanging out with them, white and black.
The fact that she's done the reveal that she's a white person and then still shows up to the group in blackface feels strange and weird.
Why is she doing it?
Pop, pop goes the popcorn as I watch movies, popcorns, and your popsicle toes because they were beautiful to me.
I am intimidated. I am truly intimidated.
Did she like swallow the mic?
I'm intimidated.
And you gotta memorize it by Tuesday.
You got it, that's fine. I am one of many wanderers searching for meaning in the story of the past. There was slavery.
Look at the face of this woman. The second she goes, there was slavery.
Phew.
Everyone over. Just stone-faced. Continue.
There was slavery. There was the Garden of Humanity, which we did labor for the fruit, which I call fire. And so many movements congested by morality.
I think that you need to write from not a topic someone gives you, but write from your heart.
I'm 17. You guys are 2 years older than me at the youngest.
That's the big difference.
Mm-hmm.
It's the 2 years of being in blackface. If she gets 2 years of doing this, maybe...
It's the, like...
It was slavery, but...
When she was saying we, I was like, let's back up.
Slow down now.
Which we are we referring to?
Because both answers are bad.
Yeah.
I really want to incorporate my experience from this project into my poem.
Throw it away.
Someone said throw it away. That's awesome. Hold on.
Throw it away. Don't throw it away.
I think that I'm gonna rewrite this.
It's the same guy that like coked her last time.
Yeah.
As one of the last things that we've done together as a group, we decided to write a letter to each other and share what we learned from one another and what we had gained from this experience.
Letters.
Bruno showing up looking like Doug's sister Judy.
Making us really think about what we've experienced through this project.
The book. She writing to her lover in the wall.
Every time we see Rose, it looks like a scene out of Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Yeah. Our overall experiments for the past 5 weeks.
I assume that they may be a bit shocked, you know.
When did he change outfits?
He's like, this is going to take 2 sessions.
It's in the dark. What happened?
Bruno said, I think they're going to be a bit shocked.
Bruno, I got to tell you, mate, they aren't.
From Renee, I wish a greater capacity for understanding on a deeper level. A reality freed from rigidity, narrow-mindedness, and petty self-righteousness.
Who, me? Someone's got a secret.
Oh my god.
Dude, he looks like he's sneaking with Scooby-Doo. He's on his tiptoes.
I really don't feel that I have learned anything from anyone in the house, but I have learned things about them. Like Bruno, no matter what color he is, he's only gonna see things his way. I think that Carmen is way too sensitive right now.
Dude, they're beefing, wrong. Dude. This is Kendrick. This is pre-Kendrick and Drake.
One of the things I learned first about the racism is that, especially from the etiquette class, that a lot of people do actually see color. Rose, for you.
All right, Bruno needs to put his fucking dogs away.
Jesus, they're going to market right now.
Those can solve a Rubik's Cube, dude. The dexterity alone.
He's holding the letter with them.
Yeah, he wrote the letter with them. I do love that everyone's standing by. I ain't learned shit from this show.
Yeah, I don't even pretend.
They didn't even try. Like, they're like, hey, just write your heart. And it's like, my heart is that Bruno sucks.
He's busted.
Y'all,
dude.
Don't see race.
Glasses are stupid.
Renee's a baby. Carmen ain't shit.
Yeah, clothes
Rose
are trash.
Is misguided.
Yeah.
She's like, I learned a few things, but she could learn a few things if you know what I'm saying. And Nick was there too.
Rose, for you, I hope for you best for your poetry in college. Good luck with that. And for everybody else, I just hope after this, wherever y'all get out of it, y'all can use from this project. and just move on with your life and do better things with it.
That is what you're supposed to say.
That's yeah,
what
they and, were he, all and supposed he did it just say. Straight off the top.
And then they all wrote it down and they're like, your shoes are ugly, you're gay. I'll kill you.
I kill you and I hate you. Hate every part of you. Your poetry's bad and so are you.
Like, what is this?
I was able to only write a little bit, so I just spoke from my heart.
Just charging up.
I have definitely learned that there is a distinction called black. All right. I'm appreciating the distinction and will continue to inquire into what it is.
Hope this email finds you well. It sounds like she's inquiring about a package from Etsy going missing or something.
About what it is, like it's the Tesseract, like some sort of mythical object she's found.
I'm investigating currently the origins of Cthulhu, seeking if the eldritch gods above have come here.
And I'll continue to inquire about what it is.
What it do?
Thank you very much. Good night.
Is she doing a closing ceremony at, like, a conference or something?
That was the fastest, like, most curt ending. Like, there had to be more.
There's pages and pages, and she's like, just scribbling that up.
Thank you so much to all of you for these last weeks together. I don't think we'll ever really be done. But hey, at least we can say we have begun a lifelong journey.
I mean, this
she's
is
right.
This is what they were supposed to write.
Yeah, like, this is like she the got point. The closest.
Nobody learned anything from me.
What was that? Okay, can we talk about that?
Nobody learned anything from me is crazy.
That seems like crap to me.
Yeah.
That's kind of a slap in the face on both of us.
Wait. Oh, so she's talking about when everybody said they didn't learn anything from them.
Yeah.
And so she's saying that's a slap in the face.
I thought she was going, hey, that sounds like crap. Are you crazy to say that? No one ever learned anything from you? Like pointing at Bruno. And so she was like, hey, good point.
Yeah. Like literally, I thought she was about to challenge him.
When we all get into therapy tomorrow, if shit jump off, it's going to be full blast.
I already know that me and Bruno is never going to agree on much of anything. Because to me, I don't think in this whole project, to me, Bruno has even tried when he's put on black makeup. And I really don't think when he's out with me in white makeup, I don't really think he gave a damn.
You've just kind of given up. You've just decided, you know what? Bruno and I just aren't gonna agree on anything.
Which is healthy, because can you imagine the amount of fucking effort it's gonna take to try to unseat Bruno's like fucking calcified views?
Dude, it is absolutely suicidal to try and facts and logic your way through someone who has no incentive to question his views.
Yeah.
It only hurts him to acknowledge what the reality. As soon as he does that, only negative things happen for him.
Yeah.
He will get nothing out of that. It is do you think they're gonna be friends afterwards? It sounds like you've given up. Yeah, the show's over.
The show's over. I'm not contractually obligated to talk to this horrible man anymore.
It sounds
just because he hasn't been on screen this episode doesn't mean we forgot what he did.
He is the protagonist and the villain.
Let's
somehow
not spin this into Brian being wrong for not wanting to be Bruno's best friend.
It seems like you don't even want to hang out with the KKK members. Yeah. Just because you don't agree with them. See ya.
Prejudice of Bell.
She walked away.
We look more alike with black.
God, he looks so funny. There's something about the like the prime lens or whatever they're using inside the car that warps his face in the funniest way. It looks like he's melting.
We look more alike with black than we do with white.
Oh, we look like we belong together more now? As black people? No.
I said we look more alike.
That conversation is insane.
How is everyone wrong?
Everyone had an unforced error.
Yeah, it was crazy.
It's like,
he was like, you ever think about how black people look the same? I don't think we'd be better if we were black. Excuse me, Bruno. She's gesturing.
You think
to
we'd
day.
Be better as a black couple? I don't think so. Is she insane? Do you hear yourself? We look more like, they just sprayed your skin.
We look more like
you.
Alike.
You have almost all of the same features, except for you've got a crazy wig on.
Except you're in like this bizarre Halloween costume that you're like yeah, we
look more alike. Black is crazy. Well, yeah, they only had one color paint.
Yeah, we both look racist.
I said we look more alike.
I hope you're not saying that all black people look alike. That shit ain't gonna fly.
Oh, wait, hold on. Progressive Bruno moment? Wait.
Is he joking, though? because he does believe it? Like, well, I hope you're not saying that because you'll get canceled these days.
Brian and I have knocked heads a little bit and have definitely seen things from a different point of view, but I think we're both going to walk away respecting one another.
Ultimately, Bruno and I don't see eye to eye on many things, but we do have a mutual respect for each other. And actually, I am glad that their family was on this project with us.
What is going on?
They play basketball and now race relations are solved.
Oh, you're right. It turns out white guys can jump.
Right, right. Huge that was like news. the main issue that Bruno had.
I have hope that racism can end.
Bad news.
Rose, thank you. First of all, I just want to say thanks.
For saying that, dude.
Wait, that's a good idea.
Yeah, I never considered it.
I came out of this experience truly with the same perspective. Race has never been an issue for me, and I don't believe I'm racist.
Okay. Well, understood. Roll credits, I guess.
Right, shit, I guess I was wrong.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Hold Whoa. On. You know what this hat needs? Another hat.
It literally needs a hat on a hat.
Maybe the coolest moment he's ever had.
That's one of the most offensive things he's ever done.
I don't know if we have an actual responsibility to share ourselves with one another, the two races.
God, there's a lot to work through there.
Yeah, I don't. That's actually...
The two races.
She threw us like a chew toy. Yeah. I don't even know if I have a hard opinion on what she just said. I need to think about it for a second.
You mean like cosmically?
Yeah.
Like religiously?
Yeah, just not against the law. Yeah.
I don't think I have to do that. You're right, I
yeah,
guess.
Yeah, sure.
Wait, what's the ethical conclusion of this show? Racism might be bad.
I think it's that integration is good. Which is, at the time of filming, a half century old concept.
The Batman Begins just came out.
Yeah.
This is not that long ago.
Not always up and up, but I appreciate it nonetheless. I wouldn't change none.
God, it really feels like the race swap element was so unimportant.
That's pretty crazy, that because it's like you could have told we could have told them that with a time machine.
They just hung out in a house. Yeah. That's what the only parts that changed,
and had a few conversations and a lot of arguments, and none of those were during the makeup part. No one felt different. I think the most we saw somebody experience something was Brian being like, damn, white people are leaving their wallets in bars.
None of us expected what we went through. We all stood through it. I just want to say thank all of you from the bottom of my heart.
Oh, this is weird. This is weird. Bruno looks like he's trying to get in.
Let me in.
Hey, please, I want uppies.
The
cameraman's like, help! Just to make sure that I understand the conclusion of that grand narrative. You put on blackface a bunch, you say the N-word a bunch, you go to a couple of locations, you say the N-word, you leave those locations, you say the N-word, you think maybe black people are being aggressive or inarticulate, and then you go home, and then you pack up your luggage a ton, and then you do some mid-poetry, and then you are confused and annoyed when, like, you call someone brother man, and they look at you weird. But have big hug. But you end with
big hug.
Big hug.
As long as you made it with big hug, dude.
If you have a big hug, that means that
you,
maybe
you finished
racism.
Filming where everyone says that they learned nothing. And then you're like, wait, we got to get the gang back together.
Nothing changed. That's the last time they
nothing
spoke
changed.
To each other.
No, literally, what changed is that they went to commercial break.
and
the
six
producers,
months went by.
The producer said, we have to say something else.
Fuck.
Can you please, please just act like you're getting along more? Well, thanks for ending this journey with us that began oh so long ago. We'll catch you guys in the next one, or if you want to, there's a long form version of this that you can find on the Jarvis Johnson Live channel. You can check us out in the coming weeks on our Patreon, patreon.com/sapboys, where we'll check out some of the DVD special features. And you can also check out the merch at sapboys.store, as well as some Patreon exclusive merch, including a $5 discount that gives you basically a month free on the Patreon at patreon.com/sadboys. So
something you can do to really treat yourself, though. Enjoy this montage.
Stay gold, everybody.
Stay gold. Goodbye. Thank you for coming in, and thanks for all the racism.
Huh?
I'm kind of waiting for somebody to go, hey,
no! Hell yeah.
No!
There's no doubt about it. Blacks are superior.
Oh my god! Holy shit!
Just, you know, mentally spar with them and go, like, you know, says, hey, nigger.
Whoa! Dude, I actually, like, had a heart palpitation.
I look forward to having someone say, hey, nigger.
Stop! doing that?
I'm going to end my life.
The fuck?
He relishes it. He genuinely loves it.
He just keeps dropping it over and over and over again. Ice Cube, do something about this.